Have you ever wondered why you wake up with a morning erection or why your partner does? Well, I'm Dr. Rena Malik, urologist and pelvic surgeon, and today we're gonna talk all about why you get nocturnal penile tumescence. If you're new here, I make weekly content on urologic health, bladder health, sexual health, and so much more. If you like what you see, make sure you subscribe and share this channel with your friends. Morning wood, or waking up with an erection, is part of what we call nocturnal penile tumescence. During the night, all humans have about 4 to 5 periods of what we call REM sleep. And during this special period of REM sleep, usually people will also have dreams, as well as penile and even clitoral erections. Interestingly, the evidence of nighttime erections goes all the way back to the time of Plato, around 327 BC. He says, and I quote, "In males, the nature of the genital organs is disobedient and self-willed, like a creature that is deaf to reason, and it attempts to dominate all because of its frenzied lusts." Wow. Later in history, in about the 17th century, erections at night, or nocturnal penile tumescence, became part of law. And this is because infertility, or the inability to have a child, became a sin and a grounds for divorce. And so erectile dysfunction became a cause of infertility. And in order to assess the presence of erectile dysfunction truly, men had to prove that they didn't have erectile dysfunction. They were subjected to external genital exams by theologians, doctors, and judges. And if necessary, members of the jury actually sat at the bedside while the person slept to assess if they had nocturnal erections. That is just crazy. It even went as far as the jury demanding elasticity and natural movement of the penis to demonstrate proper use of the penis. And so they went as far as even watching couples have intercourse. It wasn't until about 1677 that they finally stopped doing these things. That's crazy. Then it became very muddled. They started saying erections and nighttime emissions or wet dreams were about the same thing. So from the 17th to 19th century, they started calling these things pollutions, and they believed that masturbation would lead to all sorts of ailments and diseases, such as penis rings, but with sharp spikes. I mean, ouch, that sounds horrible. They also had a corset for the penis that went from the shoulders all the way to the knees. It wasn't until the 1920s when a follower of Freud, Wilhelm Steckel, declared that sleep-related erections were normal and occurred in people from all ages of infancy to old age. And the presence of morning erections, which is the last sleep-related erection, is completely normal and in fact a sign of health. They then became the leaders in the field to study sleep-related erections. They used devices that are similar to modern-day devices that measured the firmness and rigidity of the penis at night, with devices that went around the penis. In fact, they even studied this for women. They used devices to test the temperature of the clitoris, as well as a gummy balloon connected to a pressure chamber that assessed the engorgement of the clitoris. They also used different devices to measure the vaginal blood flow. And what they found was that women did have increases in vaginal blood flow, as you would expect during an erection, but they differed in the pattern compared to men. They more often had them during non-REM sleep compared to REM sleep. And all these studies essentially led to one conclusion, that these nighttime erections actually are a sign of good blood flow to the penis and a sign of good erectile health. In fact, these sleep-related erections might be protective of erectile function. So in fact, they're really good for you. The reason being is that in the erect state, you increase oxygenation to those tissues. And so having sleep-related erections is actually good to increase blood flow to the area and to make sure that you have normal erectile function when you need it. But why exactly do these erections happen? Well, there's 4 different reasons. One is the nervous system. At night, your nervous system that's most active is called the parasympathetic nervous system. And this is the nervous system that rests and digests. During that REM sleep, it causes the muscles to relax, allowing the blood to flow in, causing erections. It also causes your heart rate to slow down. The second reason this happens is due to hormonal changes. So during nighttime, norepinephrine, which is usually revved up with your sympathetic nervous system during fight or flight, goes down. As you get closer to the morning, your testosterone goes up. Both of those things together make changes in your body, which make it more likely for you to get erections. The third reason is that you can have friction against your penis if you're lying on your stomach, or sheets can rub against your penis causing erections. And lastly, in the morning, your bladder is very full and it may compress certain nerves called the sacral nerves. Then these compressed nerves can cause a reflex erection, which also explains why you often wake up with an erection. And most often that erection goes away after you urinate, but it's not necessarily completely related to the emptying of the bladder. When they've looked at men and studied them to find out exactly how many times people are having erections at night, they have about 3 to 6 episodes with at least one having an erection of greater than 60% rigidity lasting up to 10 minutes. And again, this is completely normal and in fact healthy. I get a lot of questions about how can I stop getting morning erections? Well, you can't prevent them and you shouldn't, because they're a sign of a normal, healthy individual with normal erectile function. Some people may notice that they less often have nocturnal erections, specifically because we see that men have less frequent or less rigid erections as they age. Also, people with sleep disturbances can also have more difficulty getting these sleep-related erections. So, getting your sleep evaluated is closely tied with your erectile function. So, if you're having trouble sleeping, make sure you talk to your doctor about that as well. Lastly, all these nighttime erections can help maintain the length of your penis. So if you stop having erections at night, in fact, your penis muscles may start contracting and you may have shortened penile length. Because most people wake up at the end of a REM sleep cycle. If you're getting them, great. Don't worry about it. Just be careful when you go pee in the morning not to hit yourself in the face. If you are not getting morning erections, a few times is not a big deal, but if a few months go by and you're not getting normal morning erections, make sure you go see your primary care doctor. Issues with erections can often be the canary in the coal mine, meaning it can be a sign that there might be some problem with your heart. And so it's important to get yourself checked out, make sure you don't have any heart disease, high cholesterol, high blood pressure, or diabetes that might be contributing to decreasing blood flow to the penis, which eventually can cause bigger problems down the line. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. As always, remember to take care of yourself because you're worth it.